In this video, I am going to secure movies.api project with GVT Bearer token authentication. So let's take an action. First of all, we are going to locate with the movies API. In the previous videos, we have configured the identity server. So now we are going to prepare movies API for protecting from the identity server. First of all, we are going to adding NuGet package into movies.api project. Because we will protect this API project with JVT Bearer token authentication. So go to Movies API, right click dependencies, manage NuGet packages. So we are going to install JVT Bearer authentication package. Okay, it is already installed in our package. Let me check the installed packet. Yes, we have already installed before this package and we can verify that. This package should be installed this movies API because we are going to protect our API with the JVT Bearer token. This package has including the authentication and middleware implementation in the built-in ASP.NET dependency injection package. So let me paste the second step. After that, in order to activate JVT Bearer token authentication, we should register JVT authentication into ASP.NET Core dependency injection method. For that purpose, let's go to the configuration startup CS and the configuration services. This is the ASP.NET built-in dependency injection method. So in this method, we are going to add the authentication service into the dependency injection. So let me write first and I will explain later. Okay. Yes. We have added this line of codes. Let me it's importing these namespaces. Okay, as you can see, this is basically adding the authentication dependency injection. We are registering the authentication layer in here and giving the bearer token and the other details is including the bearer token options. So we use the add authentication method to adding authentication services to the dependency injection of our web API project. Moreover, we use the add JVT Bearer method to configure support for our authorization server. In that method, we specify that authority, as you can see, we have authority. Authority, this is the address refers to our identity server in order to use when sending OpenID connect calls. And the second is the token validation parameters. This is the validate audience parameter, it is including that. Validate audience is that there is a audience value for received OpenID Connect tokens, but we don't require to check validation now. Okay, by this way, we can inject the authentication layer into the our Movies API project. So I am saving this authentication injection. And after that, of course, we should also add the authentication middleware into the ASP.NET pipeline. So go to the startup configure method and adding the authentication middleware. After the routing section, we are going to add, as you can see that we have already app use authorization and now we also require the use authentication. So after the routing, there should be use authentication, after that use authorization. So let me summarize what we are doing in the startup CS. In the configure service method, add authentication method adds the authentication service into the dependency injection and configures bearer token as a default schema. In the configure method, use authentication method adds the authentication middleware to the pipeline, so authentication will be performed automatically on every call into the host. And also in the configure method, again we use the authorization method, adding the authorization middleware to make sure our API endpoint cannot be accessed by the anonymous clients. We only allow the clients can be authorized, will be reached the actual API data operations. And finally, we should authorize the API controller, which is the movies controller in our movies API project. So by this way, we can protect our API resources. Go to controller class, go to controller folder and open the movies controller. And as you can see that we have root and API controller. Under these operations, we can adding the authorize attribute. Let me import the namespace, authorization namespace. And that's all. So by this way, we can protect our API resources with adding the authorization and authentication layer.